This is Porto in Portugal, and this is the waterfront at the River Douro, and a place called the Ribeira, if I've pronounced that correctly. And it's a busy place. This was early March, still very busy, and the weather wasn't great. This is one of the few sunny couple of hours that we got when we were there. And I'll start, as I always do, with the all-over wash, just really creating some light. The sky isn't terribly important, so I'll get a little bit of cobalt for that. Just put that on. A little bit of water then, just to move that around a little bit. I'm going to keep a little hard edge there because that's a light building. But these other ones, I'm just allowing this to essentially do what it wants to do. And really it's just going to be creating some interesting colours to begin with. So it doesn't matter that everything runs together, because this is just really painting some light on the subject. Again, doesn't really matter too much what we have here, but I want to keep that hard, but I can soften that. I don't want that to be too hard. There we go. So the lines of colour here, we've got all sorts of different coloured buildings. And again, just simple vertical lines down into the underneath part here. It's just a little bit of the blue from the sky. Keep that quite cool, because that's the far side, that's further away. And then we get down here where we have people, and we just have lots of colour here. Having said that, actually people are rarely as colourful as you think they are. So if you look at the photograph, you'll see that, okay, there's a couple of little splashes of colour, but largely, they're not that colourful, but we'll get a little bit of colour in here. Easy to do this while everything is still wet, because I'm not painting anything, I'm just putting on colour. And it's just picking up whatever I had and bringing it down, just varying things as we go and allowing that to drift. That keeps, if there's no edges, there's nothing there. Keep that in mind. If there are no edges, essentially there is nothing there. Edges create things. Soft edges don't. So I can be very simple. And that's the first wash completed. A little bit of an unfortunate cauliflower there. That's just because a little bit of my wet wash got caught up on the tape, and it has come down a little bit. Nothing really I can do about that. Certainly I'll not try and do anything about it at the moment. If it really annoys me at the end, I might try something, but at the moment I shall just leave it. So I'll start, I'll begin with whatever is furthest back. So the buildings continue right down the riverside, and obviously we've got some on the far side as well. And keep it simple, basically. There's no strong detail here. In fact, we want to avoid strong detail. So just keep it all very, very simple. A lot of little, what are essentially little horizontal lines. These are the port houses across the river. So we're sort of seeing lights on there. On their rooftops and things like that. So I'm just doing a few little horizontal lines just to hint at that. Nothing more, maybe leaving too much light there. Vary the colour a little bit. Simple, keep it simple. Buildings consist, they're tall. So let's do some tall marks. Do some tall vertical marks. Again, varying the colour. Now there's a tree in the way here, but I'm going to paint it as if the tree isn't there. So as well as the these vertical marks, there will of course also be perspective marks. So we have the essentially the height of the building, or the height of the buildings, but we will also have the perspective of the buildings, and that will be indicated by these sort of marks. Now that looks very stark, it is very stark, so what I'll do is I'll just soften that a little bit, keep it vague where I don't want it to be too strong. That's okay, this is where the tree's going to be, so I'm just going to soften that a little bit. As we get closer, some of these marks will probably, in fact will definitely, become much much clearer. But once again, I'm just trying to hint at what is there rather than be too defined about it. Once again, a few of the little perspective marks. It's a bit obvious, too obvious, but too obvious for the moment anyway. If I'm not sure about something, if I sort of think, not too sure about that, then I'll soften it. Once I soften it, it's like using an eraser. And then just working my way across. Some of the windows I'll keep light, others I shall darken. What I think I will do is I'll start the process of making the parasols from the restaurants a little bit more obvious. So down here, I'll get stronger color in down here. And at the minute, all I'm wanting to do is bring this around the edges of my parasols. Soften it, leave it hard in places, but soften it mostly, so then it sort of disappears again. So this initial stage, or these initial stages, is really just about building up little bits of interest and detail. And the next building is a rather nice reddish colour. And the same thing down here. Now again, I can use this colour to isolate the top edges of the light parasols. Go in underneath as well. So that gives me those little bit areas of light. Once again, I'll disturb some of these strong geometric shapes just so that they don't become too obvious. Next one's a yellow one, and the next one's red again. Notice that I'm allowing the red and the yellow to run together. None of the colors are absolutely pure and heavily saturated, so I can keep things relatively simple. That's all right. The wall, the stone wall then below it, a lot of this is going to be very much in sunlight, but it is darker than the parasols. So although this is light, I can't leave it the way it is because the parasols are even lighter. So if the parasols are even lighter, then my only option is to darken the area that is less light. Makes sense. Simple. Doesn't have, I don't have to darken the whole thing, incidentally. I can just, if I wish, darken the part that's going to be around the parasols. I can soften that edge up there so it gives me light, and then just a little bit of the dark. This early stage, it's important that I don't end up with too much definition, too early for too much definition. I'm still finding my way. I'm still trying to work out what's happening and what's going to happen in the painting. Try some burnt sienna, just for skin. Not a lot of skin on display. It was quite cold, but we'll get some little marks in here. Now, these will ultimately be faces, but they're just spots, so if they end up not being faces, that's okay. Should roughly be in a line, allowing for differences in height of people. So I get a little bit of my burnt sienna in there. That can be a few little figures. And maybe with some colour. What I'll do with this colour is just maybe isolate a few foreground figures. So a couple of foreground figures here, for example. There's one that's isolated now. So I can do that sort of all along here. I can just create some little lighter marks. So I create the lighter marks by adding the darker marks behind them. Trying to keep it simple. I think with a painting like this, one of the worst things could happen is that the figures become too detailed too soon. Again, little marks. These little marks will ultimately become the crowd of people. Okay, so that's the second wash, if you like. The first sort of serious wash where I'm starting to create things, create edges. But I haven't really done very much. So I'll let that dry, and we'll get on with the next stage. So I think the tree probably I'll do next. I haven't got anything of that tree in, so I need to get something with the tree in. The tree is relatively dark, not all of it, but a lot of it is dark. So it's going to look a bit too much. It'll be too strong in relation to everything else. But I have to commit myself to darks at some stage. And I want to vary this, so I don't want it all to be dark or light. I need to vary it quite a lot. Probably should have had more light over there. Let me just lift a little bit of that out, just with my softening brush. It's better. And I'm sort of jiggling the tip of the brush up and down so that I get this these little very uneven edges. Very uneven. Let's get that a little bit darker now. And I'm coming down to the point at which we're going to be getting some branches starting to appear. I get a smaller brush for this. I'm just trying to get a rough shape for this tree. Letting it all blend in together, that's the important thing. And just trying to get some of the little finer branches then appearing. But that now gives me something that I can work with, because now I have to balance everything with that, basically. So now I know where my... That's essentially the strongest dark. So I need to be careful. There is nothing as strong as this from this building back. So I have to be careful not to go too strong. It's not going to be difficult because I'm still thinking of distance here, but out here, for example, it can get some added strength with these little marks. Doesn't say much, but it's enough to give me the suggestion of the water over there. Remember, it's a small part of the painting, so it doesn't need to be particularly strong. It just needs to be, I suppose, vaguely interesting. That's really all I'm looking for, vague interest. Again, these background buildings. There's quite a lot going on back there. It's basically with distance. Whatever you see, never make it as detailed as you see it. Because if you do that, you will tend to lose the suggestion or the illusion of depth in your painting. So in other words, don't be too literal with what's back there. So I'm literally now just sort of doing some little marks that I'm hoping will suggest people. Just little marks. There's something like that. It just hints at what's going on there. Back here, the same thing. Need a little bit more, but it's going okay. Now in here, it's all very vague. Even in the photograph, it's quite difficult just to make out what's happening in here. So from that point of view, I don't want to make it too strong, but I do need to be careful with my little marks that I'm making, that they all tie in with the perspective of the subject. So the windows, for example, need to be sloping up. Oh, I'll get a little bit of colour on my steps here. Can't help it. Just little simple suggestions, that's all. onto my main building. There's a nice sort of red roof to it. A little bit strong, I think. Down below, a little bit of the red, just to spread the colour around a little bit. The yellow is a little bit too flat, so I want to vary that a little bit. Really, this just means going in and sort of putting a couple of almost little random marks around the place, and then I'll just soften the edges at this stage. Gives me a little bit of variety. There's also stonework that's going to be a little darker. There is a darker part just in there, and that helps to show up the light on the edge of my stonework here. So we'll get that in, get it softened. So as I say, I'm looking to see what little marks are already here that I can utilize to make my figures. So the ones in the distance first, they're going to be the simplest. So I should say, trying to get the suggestion of figures without actually being too defined about them. Not sure about that one. If you're doing these and it doesn't quite work, just get rid of them. A little bit lighter, just a little bit of water, just to take this over my building here. I don't want it too dark. I don't want to kill all that nice color. But this is all in shade. And the same mix for my shadows on my parasols. dry up these drips here. As I was saying, this isn't really an important part of the painting. It's not the focus of the painting, so I don't want to be getting too caught up in any sort of detail. All these little marks just help to give interest. Right. These marks are all purely for variety. Again, just looking for little suggestions of the structures of the people. And some of them, again, just a little bit too strong. Okay, the tree is still by far the darkest part of the painting, so I need to get some stronger darks in. So I'll use the same as I used for the shadows. That's the phthalo and the red. That gives me a good, rich dark. Right, let's go back a little bit because I need to match some of these darks in with the tree. Woohoo, that's strong. But it is quite strong. So, and actually the steps are stronger. And in here, little marks. Nothing too strong, but again, just something to balance the tree, basically. So I need to get quite a bit of extra dark in here. Just building up. I'm trying to keep sort of light, dark, light, dark, light, dark, that type of thing. Yeah, these ones at the front are still a little bit sort of too soft, I suppose. Varying the windows so that no two are exactly the same. Just want to vary the, they're all on the same plane. I just want to try to vary them a little bit so that some are further up, some are further down. Okay, a little bit of warmth, I think, in the ground. Yeah, I think that helps. Thin the colours. few more little marks here and there, just. Something like that is much too obvious, but once I soften it a little bit, it becomes much better. Softening it in places. This is the important thing. All these little bits of softening all help. Little bits of green here and there as well. And the little bits of extra green help to balance what we have here. A little bit of green in there just helps to suggest some of the, there is a little bit of vegetation in there, but the real reason is it just helps to balance the tree. So even if there hadn't been vegetation there, I would have been tempted to put it in. Yeah, there's a touch of water. Just here. That nice bright blue, does that go anywhere? Well, why not? It just gives me a few little extra, just where the darks have maybe spread a little bit too much. As long as we can see a few heads, we don't really need to be worrying too much about the rest of the bodies. Well, we do. We need to worry about proportion, but other than that, back up here, I feel we could get a little bit more strength in places. Very fine lines up here, obviously, so it's always a little bit of a problem. Yeah, what really happened here, although I don't want to draw too much attention to these buildings, the problem is that they weren't balanced with the rest of it, so I need to get some more strength in, just to balance things. Yeah, that's giving me a little bit of variety up there. Some little figures up here as well. Variety. Just need to get this bit behind here a little bit stronger so that we can see the wall, the light wall against the slightly darker background. In there. All right. On the ground here, there are the little joins in the pavement, and might be better doing that with the ruling pen. So the little ruling pen. Some colour. And then basically I just stroke the brush on the pen and it fills up the gap between the little blades. Thinking of the perspective. So all of these lines disappear to a single point on eye level, the usual perspective idea. and the horizontal lines will just be horizontal. Well, technically they'll disappear way, way over to the right. Pigeons? Where are pigeons about? Basically just little triangles. And a touch of shadow coming from them, obviously. Obviously, the closer they are, the bigger the little triangle becomes. And I'm leaving a little gap below the triangle before I do the shadow. And that is simply because the birds are standing with their on their legs, obviously. And rather than do the legs, I just leave a little gap. Okay, strong darks. So, where? I think I can afford to do a few little darks up in here. So I'm doing much less than I've already done. But these little darks all help to just create a little bit of focus. I don't really want to draw attention to this, but I still feel I need a touch of these darks just to again balance things a little bit. So I'll not do as much as I did here. Little hint of a bag and things, just a couple of little extra suggestions of interest. This, it's always a little bit daunting, this type of subject, where you have all of these people. And it's important to remember that because there are so many people, so long as you have a couple of figures that are reasonably well painted and well proportioned, that's really all you need, because the rest of it is implied. So our brains are very good at taking a little bit of information and making a lot from it. Again, just some of these faces could do with being a little bit stronger. The suggestion of the little slope down to the jetty, or well, down to the water. Few little, oh, that's a bit much. Few little touches just of it's these are just little marks to sort of stop anything becoming too tidy. You know, it's not particularly tidy. It's busy. It's vibrant. Things going on. So these little marks can help to just add to that suggestion. Now, some of those are perhaps a little bit too much. I will take them off a little bit. So splatter them on, take them off. Back over here. Again, just a vague indication of something there. A little bit of white, perhaps. And this is really far in here. I can get just little highlights on around a figure's head or something like that. You know, that one in there, for example, there's no figure there at all. It doesn't look right close up like this, but once we look at it back, it looks fine. So let's take the tape off. Let's see what it looks like. Always gives a much better idea. And I think we have it there, the Ribeira, if that's the right pronunciation once again, in Porto, in Portugal.